your boy Aces for Aces on the Go. How everything's going down. Now to let y'all know what happened with my camera, the Roto Cam. So I'm gonna tell y'all the whole big scoop about this thing. I was happy in some parts and disappointed in a couple parts. Let's just talk about this real quick. Okay, I did got this as a good deal, guys. You know what I'm saying? $8.99. You get this whole unit plus the camera. You can't go wrong because in the long run, you can always change the camera and still keep this part. This is the main part right here. But the camera is not actually that bad, guys. This antenna right here, guys, I ain't gonna lie, in the beginning, I thought it was a 5.8 gigahertz antenna. And if that was the case, this camera would have been awesome. But it's not the case, guys. It's Wi-Fi. Now, I found out the specs of this. A lot of people get it confused because of their phone. Some people thought it was 720 and stuff like that. It's actually a 1080p HD cam. I'm telling you that right now. This is exactly what it is. But if you have a slow phone, then it will show 720. So that it's like based on your phone, like, but it's actually really a 1080p. Because I put on my phone, it's 1080p HD. But the only flaw with this damn thing, it's Wi-Fi, guys. And you know how Wi-Fi goes with 2.4 gigahertz. It doesn't match. It messes up. So, let me tell you what happened. It's clear on my phone. It looks nice. If you want to take pictures, no problem. It looks nice. But the Wi-Fi, because it's Wi-Fi, it freezes a lot. You get a nice video, then the video will freeze. Then it comes back 30 seconds later, then freeze. And I guess it depends on your phone. I seen one video that it'll constantly on. So it could also be based on the phone, but with my phone, it was freezing. And I don't dig that, you know? And then when I had it on my truck, man, I drove my truck a couple of times. I know how far my truck will go. This thing, when you have a Wi-Fi connected, like, well, mostly all 2.4 gigahertz, it always messes it up. Well, my truck, I could easily get 100 meters like it's nothing. Nothing. I changed up the radio. I changed up everything, so I know I get distance with it because I tried it out before. But when this is on it, I'm not going to lie to you guys. I think I got, like, maybe, like, 25, 30 meters. That's it. And my shit stalled. I'm like, what the hell? I had to adjust my hand to get the frequency to get back in so I can make a U-turn and come back. The Wi-Fi, I hate it. So that's the only thing that sucks about this unit is Wi-Fi. Oh, and on another note, on here, for some reason, I want y'all to see this. I don't know if y'all can see it. It says Apple and Android. It's no Apple, guys. I even tried on my Apple device, and it shows Android even though you click here on Apple. And I tried to find the app, and I can't find the app at all for Android. So, guys, if you have for Apple. So, guys, if you have an Apple device, the ISO, you won't be able to use this unit. But Android is no problem. Once you got an Android, you will easily work and operate this thing. That's the one, that's another flaw. I couldn't get it from my Apple. I really wanted it from my Apple because I wanted to put it on my tablet device and really get some use out of it and really could record long and stuff like that. Because with your phone, I don't got too much memory in my phone, so I'm trying to record a lot of stuff. So I will be changing this camera out, though, guys. I'm telling that right now. I want to put a 5.8 gigahertz camera on this. Matter of fact, I think the camera that I replaced on the SEMA is a 5.8. It's one of those 5.8. It comes with the camera that comes with the monitor. I might use that setup on here. It's more easy to use. I don't have to use my phone. The camera itself, the camera that comes with it, have its own battery just like this. So I attach that to this, and I can put that monitor on my remote. And boom, instant video as it going around. So that's exactly how I'm going to do it. I did a short video, though. I got a short video. And actually, the video is supposed to have been 2 minutes long of me driving, testing it out. It really, I only got like 30 seconds of video. It shows me driving off. And for some reason, it shows me already, I'm already back. The time I went up that sidewalk, it was frozen. And I didn't know it was froze. Cause I had the phone on the floor as I was watching the vehicle. Cause I didn't have my phone attached to my remote because I had my own monitor connected to my truck. So I was watching my monitor, not watching the phone. And then when I came back and I made that U-turn, I noticed that it was frozen. Then it unfroze. That's the reason why I didn't mess with it. And I got the ending of the video. So I have that to show y'all so y'all can see the quality of this thing. But let me show you the app, though. Plug this in. I think I still have it charged up enough. And I'm going to go to the app. Oh, first, you have to sign into that Wi-Fi. So, I'm going to sign into the Wi-Fi. And wait for it to pop up. And when it pops up, I hope y'all could see this. I don't think y'all could. See that? The V, what's that? VSL cam. That's the one you need. You click onto that. Wait till it's connected. Okay, I'm connected. Then I go back out. I go to the app, which is right here. That's the app. It's called Velocity Video. And then it looks like this. Can y'all get that? Press play. And voila. Look at that. It's HD. Like I was telling y'all, see? See, it freezes every now and then, and then it comes back. I want y'all to see that. Right now, it's frozen. See, that's what you go through when you're dealing with Wi-Fi, guys. You're dealing with stuff like that. You have a frozen screen, and you have to wait for it to come back. So you get the rest of the video. That's the only problem with this thing. But I did see a guy who made a video with this, and I don't know what's wrong with his phone. It was showing 720 though, but it was flowing. It was still moving. It wasn't that clear, but it was actually working. But it also depends on your phone if you want to get that good HD video. You could take pictures with it, take videos with it. Everything you could do with the app, it could be done. So, I'm going to show you how I had it mounted on the truck, then I'm going to show you all the video. So, let's do this. Okay, right here, I have it mounted on the truck. And you can see it's on. And it's a delay. Until I get my hand in front of it. So, you can see my hand. See, it's a delay. Crappy delay. See it? It's probably like maybe a half a second delay on it. Well, that's what you get when you have Wi-Fi devices. But as you can see, it is a HD video. And if it worked perfectly without cutting off, man, I actually would have kept the camera on there and have fun with it. And even though it shortened your range, I just keep it close to me and just make action videos. But because it does that, I gotta change the camera. Now, someone asked me, can you rotate the arm? Yes, you can. See, right here, stuck. I didn't want to use the sticky tape. I used one of my wife's, what is baby called? The squingy? Squingy?
Hair tie.
Yeah, well, her hair tie, her squingy. I used that to tie it on here. It looks neat. I could take it off anytime I want. See it? I didn't want to actually stick it on there, but it's on there nice. But if you want this to rotate, there's a knob in the back. You pull it back. Pull it back, and you can swivel any way you want in the vehicle. You can have it to the front, have it to this side, any way you want. And this knob, of course, I showed y'all, once you loosen it, you go back and forth. So now I'm going to show y'all the quick little, a couple seconds video I have, and then I'm going to end this video, guys. So here we go.
Years of selling Johnson & Johnson. I started out as a baby face monster. No wonder it's diaper rash on my conscience. My teething ring was numb by that nonsense. Gemstar razor and a dinner plate. Arm and hammer and a mason jar, that's my dinner date. Then crack the window in the kitchen, let it ventilate. Cause I let it sizzle on the stove like a minute steak. Nigga, I was cracking the school zone. Two beepers on me, started jacket that was two-tone. Four lockers, four different bitches got they mule on. Black Ferris Bueller cutting school with his jewels on. Couldn't do wrong with a chest full of chains and an arm full of watches. What I sell for.
Okay, guys, that was my quick little video of it. Well, actually, it's not a bad unit, don't get me wrong. For beginners, y'all won't mind that. But if you're a hobbyist, it will bother you. Like me, I'm a hobbyist. Little things like that will bother me, but I can't complain because only $8.99. Now, if I was paying the full price, how much it was, I'd have been pissed off. I really would have been pissed off. But since I didn't pay that much, I can't get mad. Because, like I said, I could still use that. But to change the camera, I could use the rest of the unit part of it, and it's good. Because just getting a piece to hold the camera, it could run you from $15, $20, $30 just for that one piece alone. Depends what kind you get, what kind of counterweight you have. It depends. So I'm still happy just having that part of it. Put my own camera on there and voila, I'm good. But if you're a beginner, you can just leave it just like that. Mess around with your phone. If you keep your vehicle or your quad close to you, hey, well, I can't say quad. That's too heavy for quad. I don't even know why I said that. Or your RC. You keep it close when you want to drive close. You keep it close to you. The reason why I said quad, because I had this in mind. Because I had this on there too. Guys, man, this thing's a lifesaver, man. Sky RC, oh my God. This speed meter is awesome, guys. And it's nice and light enough that you could fly. Yo, the Bugs 3, Bugs 8, even the Bugs 3 Mini could pick up this thing. That's how good this thing is. It's nice and light. It could pick up this thing. So now you can know the speed and the height of your quad. Just in case your transmitter is not giving you the right feed and you don't know exactly what you're doing, get one of these. You will know exactly what fast you're going, how the height is, and then you go to Google's map, guys, and you can watch the whole thing that you did, how you did it, how you zigzag, how high you went, where you was at. Everything will be on Google map through this thing. This thing is awesome. And I will be putting this on my RC. I already have my Velcro on it. I have Velcro on all my RCs. I'm ready to strap it down, and I'll be testing the runs on all my things. I'm saying it bring new life into your RC products. This right here, guys, I'm not going to lie, it's good to have. I'm not trying to take it away from the cam, but I had to throw that in. Since I didn't really made a video for this, I had to throw that in. If you're a hobbyist, this is a must-have, guys. You got to get this. Well, anyway, that's the end of my video. I hope y'all enjoyed. I talk too much. I'm about to go hang out with my wife. But I want everybody around the world, I want you to have a good morning, a good afternoon, and a good night. Hey, press that like button. Yeah, you might like this. And if you don't, I'm not even going to sweat it. It's all good. It's all right. We all love here. We family. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed before. And if you don't do that, it's all good. Everybody should know that by now. You wanna know why? Cause your boy Ace has got love for you. Press that bell button. You might want to have something you might want to see later. You could check me out. It's all good. You don't have to watch me right now. You click me on, hit the bell, you watch me later, and then you can enjoy it when you relax. It's all good. I want everybody out there to enjoy your hobby. Don't forget that. Stay hydrated. Everything's all good. And until I see y'all to the next video, I love everyone out there. Peace.